you believe in, I think these are the kind of candidates we'll get, and it's amazing.
Steve, let me ask you something. Let me press my luck. You say that you think DeSantis should have apologized for what he said. Fair point. Do you think the president should apologize for saying if the GOP loses in the midterms, there will be violence? First of all, if you win, you don't have to be upset about it. There's no reason to act out. But violence? Why stoke that kind of fear?
I'll tell you why. He's not stoking fear. He's recognizing the reality out there. On the very unfortunate reality in America is that political violence is on the rise.
If you win?
On the rise on both the right and the left. Look, it may be regardless, but it might even be more so if the Republicans win. Yes, because they might feel more
despondent. No, he says if we lose, it's going to be violent. Preachers, he said. Preachers, help me in the pulpit, right? Because if we lose, they are going to be violent. They're violent people.
Yeah, and by the way, a lot of them are. And Antifa is who he was talking about. Antifa is them. Chris, look, when a thug puts on a mask, okay, whether that mask is a racist Klansman's hood or whether it is a radical Antifa's black mask, first of all, when you put on a mask and it's not Halloween, you're up to no good, clearly. But when they do that and they resort to political violence, which has been done on both sides, it is totally unacceptable in decent society in America.
Who disagrees with that? If you break the law, then you're a rioter and a thug and a criminal. What does that have to do with what happens if
you
lose the
election? You know who disagrees with it? You know who disagrees, unfortunately, Chris? You do, because you equivocated on this very point.
I never equivocated on anything.
You tried to explain
a bit. Let your writing mouthpieces twist my words for effect to enhance a bigoted agenda. And now you're going to sell it.
No,
and it's a mistake on this show.
No.
I said very clearly, and people can check my words, you break the law, you're a criminal and a thug. I said, don't create an immoral equation between those who preach hate and those who fight it, because not all punches are equal.
Hold on.
And I stand by that.
Endorsed
Antifa.
Don't
sell BS to my face. Do it behind my back when you're better at it.
No, Chris, I'll do it to your face. Antifa, by the way, hates a whole lot. If you watch the Antifa
riots, I'm not pro-Antifa.
Really,
I don't even know who makes up the organization. And if they break the law, they're criminals. And this is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about.
Don't say that they're anti-hate.
Your way of listen, this is my point, Steve. You know, if you looked at the words, which unfortunately we both know you didn't, you read your little buddies at Breitbart and the little niche places that you say need to have more time on Google, and you came up with Cuomo didn't beat down Antifa or not. Untrue. I said if you break the law, you're a criminal. It's not good enough for you guys. You know why? You want to divide. And I'm wondering if it'll work for you.
Chris, you also said that Antifa, you said Antifa is fighting hate. And I'm saying Antifa is doing
everything
as much
hating
as any racist
in Charlottesville. I didn't say Antifa. Look at the words. I'll bet you dinner.
Well, and
final word to Angela Rye.
Well, the president.
You have three misstatements. That's it. You're in the
box. The president was talking Antifa.
Angela Rye, final word to you.
Yes, here's the biggest problem. I think Donald Trump read an old Snopes piece where they debunked this whole thing. They said that Antifa was calling for a civil war. That's not real. That's fake news. And I know as much as you all like to say, Steve, right, like alternative facts and truth is not truth. It actually is. And facts still matter. And so I think I would encourage you all to understand the importance of fighting violence on all sides. No one that sets foot on this network condones violence. All violence begets violence. We cannot endorse it. We cannot support it. There's no room for it. Maybe y'all can stop with the talking points now.
Listen, Steve, I'll make it easy for you, because obviously I have no problem backing up what I say on television. Look at what I said and look at how it was reported, and what you're going to see is an extension of an ugliness that we don't need. If I wanted to be unfair, I wouldn't have you on the show. I have you on a lot because I want to hear what you have to say.
I
appreciate having you here. You find where I said I back Antifa. Dinner's on me, wherever you want, and I know you got a big appetite. Angela Rye, you buy your own dinner.
Jesus.
With that big following on Instagram, you don't need my help. Have a good night to both of you. Thank you.